Good afternoon, my fellow enthusiasts, and yes, it is Wednesday afternoon, so that means it's another part in my Dark Souls Let's Play series. I hope you guys are as excited as I am. In the last part, I kind of ventured into the, what was it called? The, like, Undead City, I think it was called, right? Undead Settlement, and kind of explored around there and gathered some things. Now, I've also been watching some other Dark Souls Let's Plays on YouTube and have been just thinking a little bit about like some stuff that I left behind in the very beginning of this thing. So like that giant lizard creature that we saw in the beginning. I can't go back and fight him. I was hoping that I could go back and fight him, and because I saw that he gives you a Titan Shard. Why can't I not go? What's going on? Why is everything blocked? Is it because I traveled? Do I have to travel back here? Travel. I'm already at the Firelink Shrine. Oh, okay, I can just travel back this way. So, Cemetery of Ash. Now, let's go to the Cemetery of Ash Bonfire. That's what I have to do. And then, so that giant lizard creature, he might be a bit easier to fight now that I've leveled up a little bit. But he is going to give me, like, large Titanite shards and pieces of equipment that I can use to level up my weapons. So I'm going to go back and try and fight him. As well as there is a special weapon in Firelink Shrine on the top level, and there's going to be, unless they patch the game, which I don't think they have, at least to fix it, there's a way to get up there without having to buy the tower key for 20,000 souls. So I'm going to try and do that myself if I can. And if I can do it, then that means that you guys can do it too. So let's see if we can do that. First, let's go after. I should have maybe probably used my souls, like purchase upgrades. But oh well. I'm gonna try and take out this this lizard creature thing that we got coming on here. It's supposed to drop some, like I said, some Titanite, like large Titanite shards and stuff. You little crystal lizard. Come on, don't. Yeah, you better not be that tough. Yeah, he's pretty tough. Ow. Okay. Not happening there. Oh my god, that's a powerful bite. Jesus Christ. Oh, I staggered him. Sweet. Did I kill him? Oh yeah. Titanite scale. That's what I'm freaking talking about. There you go. So I see he wasn't that. Oh, he gives a 4,000 things of freaking souls. All right, that was totally worth it. And it wasn't even that hard of a fight. So yeah, so once you gained up a couple levels, definitely go back here and try and fight this guy. The Titanite scale will help you upgrade your weapons even further, which is great. So definitely worth a trek back. Now I'm gonna go and level up a little bit, because the guy who has the special weapon, He's gonna have the katana, the special katana, and he's supposedly kind of tough. So we'll see how I do. If I can't handle him, then we'll continue on in our journey in the Undead Settlement and see where we go from there. So yeah, we'll just fast travel. We'll just travel back to Firelink Shrine. I was wondering why that's all fogged out. Is it because like I'm undead or something? I have no idea. Is it still fogged out? But I can't get up in that way? I was able to get up before. If it's because I'm hollow, as they say, then I'll use an ember. But it's kind of shocking that... Huh? It's a fog wall. Yes, I will applaud because it's true. Well, maybe they are patching it and they've locked that up. Oh man, that sucks. So it looks like I'm gonna have to spend 20,000 souls, maybe. Damn it, From Software! Damn you! Ooh, who are you? Oh no, that's the fire shrine lady. Alright, let's level. Let's go get some of the souls that I picked up and use them. I get another 10,000 or so. Bam! 11,000. Sweet!
Welcome home, Ashenlands.
Hello!
Thine heart's desire.
I wish to level up.
Then touch the darkness within me.
I will.
Take nourishment from thee.
Okay. Alright, so I kind of want to up my dexterity a little bit, but I should also do my strength, because I need a lot of strength. Let's up my dexterity to 15. And... let's go my endurance to my stamina. Nah, vigor. It's alright, vigor. Alright. Well, that also leaves me with little souls, which is good. Which means I won't worry so much about dying. Now let's go and see if I can't upgrade some things.
Ah, well met. Tis good to see you. Pardon me.
Let's reinforce weapons. Additional items required. Alright, so it looks like I can't... What else do I need to upgrade? Show info? No. Oh, I need 4 Titanite shards. Okay, I only have 2. Alrighty, well then that's fine. Well, you can't infuse, right? No, because I don't have anything to infuse them with. Right. Okay. Goodbye. Now there's... I'm gonna go buy some more bolts, because actually I learned where quite a few other weapons
Heavens.
Were. So I might go curled up.
Heavens.
This was already dead. Oh well, okay, I can't buy from you now, sir? That's kind of lame. And then here's our friend. So supposedly if you talk to him,
champion,
he gives you level up for free. But you become more ashen, which means you look more and more like a zombie.
This pilgrim, with a debt in death, hardly deserves to behold this divine. And I never would have, had you not taken me into your service. I thank you dearly for this, and assure you of my leal.
Draw out true strength.
Then shall we begin?
Yes.
Bearer of the dark sign, let your true strength shine.
So yeah, he basically gives you a free level up. Which I think is freaking cool. So I could up my strength or dexterity or my vigor. Actually, see, this ups it to 680. This only ups it by 4. Let's see. Well, okay, nothing really is going to give me a lot, if I except for the health. So let's do the health. That never hurts to have more health in a stabbing game. And so eventually, and he also sells you spells, but I'm not going to be a spell person. Attack with a greatsword formed from souls. Oh, that sounds interesting. So yeah, then you go and... Then you're supposed to kind of go and kill yourself by falling off the top of the shrine and sort of rinse and repeat every once in a while, and he gives you a free level up. Not like it seems like I'm going to take a while to die. Unless there's like an even bigger... Oh yeah, I could go up over that way and try and jump off. That's true. That's true, Sebastian. You should be thinking with your head. Go up this way. Jump! Whee! Okay. Is this gonna leave it? A little bit. Okay. No point in, like, running around all the way up there if I don't need to. And then... Okay, died. You died! No, really? Alright, where'd be my souls? My souls up top? There they are. Not that I had a lot, but still. Souls retrieved. So yeah, where are my stats? So now you'll see that I have this hollowing point. So I think every 5 hollowing points you get, you can go and get a free level from him. So it might be worth your while to do that. Alright. I'm just going to check again, make sure the fog, see if the fog is gone. I doubt it. Yeah, fog's not gone. Alright, so that's annoying. So let's continue where we were. Actually, I'm going to go and try and grab some interesting, some things. So we're going to go back to the high wall of Lorthric. Because you can get a claymore here, you can get a special axe around here. So it's worth checking out. And if you can hurt the dragon that spits fire, like in Demon Souls, you get a whole access to a whole like group of things, and he'll fly off. And if you kill him, and if you don't even have to kill him, as long as he just kind of flies off, you will gain also like a dragon scale titanite shard kind of thing, which is great. Another thing, certain enemies are weak to fire, I found out, and they'll like flail on the ground and give you like free hits, and dogs are one of them. So if you have fire weapons or fire bombs or whatever, and you have a type of enemy that's giving you problems, definitely see if they have that weakness. I know that also the tree guys in the swamp have that, so definitely give it a check. And then also those guys that I ran away from that have that black creature coming out of their backs. He's gonna be this guy here. They give you tight. Once they transform, and you can kill them, they give you also shards. But you have to kill them in this form. You can't kill them when they're like still. Oh my god, weak. But see, they're still tough. They're still really tough. That's why I don't have very many souls. That's why I'm trying this out when I don't have very many souls. Nope. Ow! Alright, that was good timing on your part. Ooh, what'd you give me? Light crossbow. Not like I need it because I already got one. So I don't know if you can hurt that guy a little bit, and then he'll kind of go, and he'll have that same health when he transforms. So maybe that's something I will try now. I'll try and go after him first. Maybe not kill him, but at least hurt him enough where I can go after him and win with certainty, with some form of certainty. So let's grab my souls. Oh, he's dead, so it doesn't really matter. So he's a one-hit kill, so I didn't get the Titanite shard. I can always come back and get it some other time. But yeah, if you kill them, you get more shards. You get Titanite shards. So higher levels, it might be worth to come and try and hunt these dudes down. Now, I don't know if I have enough crossbow to take out the dragon. Well, you don't have to kill the dragon, but... to harm the dragon, so we will have to see, because Mr. Frickin' Thief over there didn't seem to want to sell me anything. Ow. Ow. Okay. You are a pain in the ass, sir. Alright, I'm not going. I don't need to go that way. To go around. Right, yeah, it's down this way. So you go through this way. You're gonna fight these dudes. Come on, swing at me. Swing at me. Also, if you notice that there's a sound difference when you kill certain enemies, then then that means that you're kind of doing sort of like a critical hit. So if the hit sounds really hard and heavy, that means you've kind of done extra damage. So it's not just the stagger, but sometimes you can get crits. A lot of little things like that. I mean, typical Dark Souls fashion. You're basically going to be playing the game, just running around looking for things. So there's the dragon. You can hear him screaming and hollering. Trying to stay upbeat. So up there's the dragon. You can kind of, if you have enough bolts, you can kind of shoot him away. Ow. Kind of wish these guys would... Oh, he's going to spitfire down here. That's not good. Well, it is good for me, but... Alright, so... Give me things. Longsword. Give me things. Another longsword. So you're gonna have to fight this knight in order to clear this sort of area. You guy? Yeah, you're a guy. Well, you don't actually have to, but I might want to. I'm gonna want to. Come on, knight. Let's see what your type is like. Oh god, he's gonna come at me with the combo. Alright, got him. Whew. Alright, so. Forgot how to shoot. There you go. Yeah, see, it's gonna take. Holy crap, I didn't realize he was gonna spit fire down here. Oh my god. Alright, that would have been nice to know. They didn't explain that in the... Nobody explained that he was going to shoot fire down here. So, tip first, be inside somewhere safe a little bit where you can shoot the dragon. I don't think he can can't hit us here. Oh, no. Stupid wasting bolts. I only got like a few left. Nope, missed him. Great. Let's see if I can get him to go away. That'd be great, but I don't think I have enough arrows. Yeah. Yeah, I don't have anywhere near enough arrows. I'm gonna have to go buy some more arrows. Or bolts, or whatever. Because... Oh my god, that still hurts! So, we could try and brave it. Because it allows you to also go in there. Thank you. I don't trust you, dragon. Oh my god, am I gonna make it? I made it. Whew. Okay, so that wall kind of protects. Oh god, but there's still fire everywhere. So yeah, you're gonna have to try and find a way to get rid of him. Which again is usually with arrows. So I might have to go and go back and buy arrows. Which is annoying. Okay, so it's this way and this, and then I can get back to the shrine. Oh, it might be better to shoot him from up here. Alright, let's travel. Sorry, this one might be a little bit more about the secrets of the first part of the game that I found from various other YouTubers and doing my own research. So we'll check it out. You know, I'm just trying to do something a little bit different here. If you guys don't like it and you want me to just continue with the story, let me know in the comments of this video.
You know I'm a petty thief.
Yes.
Everyone's dead or hollowed away anyway, right? So I might as well fetch some weapons or treasure for you.
Yeah.
Well, what do you say?
Send him to pillage.
Grey Rat the Thief was once a well-known name.
Wait, does that mean that you're going to go away now?
Until I ended up rotting.
Okay, good. I can still purchase that. Sorry. Alright, I want a Manet Knife, Bastard Sword, the Spear. So I'm going to need more bolts. So I'm going to buy as many bolts as my souls can allow. And let's see, is there anything I can sell that's not worth anything? Okay, I have these two long swords. They're just going to give me 100 souls each. This is a light crossbow. They're both light crossbows. I don't use arrows, so sure, take those as well. Alright.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Now go pillage. So he's gonna go out and he's gonna, every time you kill a boss, you can tell him to go out and pillage, and he'll come back with weapons and armor and that sort of thing. Alright, so let's rest at the bonfire. We'll travel, we'll go back to the tower and try and shoot that dragon away. See if I can do that. It's probably going to take a while, so I'll probably fast forward through this part of the video. I might just do that. I might just like have you guys not see this until I'm done with it, so that way it's not too boring. So I'll be back in a second, guys. All right, guys, I'm back, and as you can see, that the dragon is still there. I had purchased 72 arrows and had hidden from most of them. A couple hit those two spires over there since I can't lock on from over here. And I've maybe taken about a third of his health down with those 72 arrows. So it's definitely going to be super time consuming. You're going to have to probably, especially early on, you're probably going to have to buy as many arrows as possible, probably well over 100, to whittle them down. Or have a very high dex build. Because that will help you out. And also another thing, you can shoot him from up here, but it's not advised because his fire actually reaches you up here too. So go down into that little corridor over there. Just kill the dude hiding in the boxes. Forget about the knight. Let him walk out a little bit and then shoot the dragon. And the dragon's gonna spit fire and kind of kill everybody in that area. And you're gonna get a few souls. So that's a good thing. So now, since that's kind of a fail on my part, we're gonna go back and we're gonna adventure forward. No more trying to find too many things, because I really, the only other thing I kind of know how to do in this beginning area is get rid of that dragon. You can get a claymore, you also get the deep sea axe, I believe, and then you can kind of go from there. I don't know where this is going. Can I open this? Doesn't open from the side, so I'm gonna have to go and fight that sumbitch over there. There's also a secret if you want to get to the probably one of the more reclusive covenants in the game. You remember those sort of caged creatures that I fought? Let's see how I do against finding this. Oh god, it's just running. Oh, ow. Not locked on. Blood loss. Okay, but I killed him. Fucking hell. Alright, so I'm gonna have to drink a couple Estus flasks. Off the bat. Fantastic. So if you remember those cage guys that I found, they're kind of like over in that corner. If you go to that area where the guy killed me with the giant pot, and you kind of jump down, you'll see one of those big dudes with a cage in his back, and if you get inside that cage, he's not going to attack you. And if you get inside that cage, then he will take you to one of the harder covens to find. Oh my god, what is going on? What the hell? What is there, a ballista? Oh god, oh god, this is not good. This is not good. Oh shit! Oh god! Oh lordy Jesus! I don't even know where I am. I don't even know where I am. Okay, I'm hiding out here. Ooh, got some. Oh, a little sneaker here. He's dead. So it looks like those things can't hit us from over here. That's good. That makes me feel good. Also, this is where you can. This area is where you can get Mortician's Ashes, which you need to get in order to do an NPC quest line. So, might be good while you're up this way to grab them. And also, I think that's chilling right there. Whatever this is. Oh God. Whatever this that is right there. And I failed. Whatever that little sparkling thing is over there is, I think, is supposed to be a hollowed bone, which is supposed to allow you to upgrade your Estus flasks. And I think that's the first one you get. So you might want to take a chance and try and grab it. But I'm very bad at the jumping in this game. Ow! Alright. Ow. Okay. Alrighty, so now I'm gonna have to try and survive all of that again. I guess these little, ballista bolts should have been a sign. Come on, where are they coming from anyways? Oh, they're coming from that tower? Yeah, let's see if I can't grab my souls. Okay, I got my souls back. Let's keep going. Jump! Oh my god, there's a whole crew of them. Okay. Get up. Oh, I didn't realize that that thing could hit me from there. I thought I was safe. Guess not. Okay, you want to come at me? Okay. Jeez. And there's so much, loot over there. But let's see what's in there. Oh god, there's gonna be a... Looks like a red-eyed motherfudger. He's gonna come at me. Nope. Okay, not that tough, though. Not that tough of a red-eyed motherfudger. He gave me another harpy. Okay. So I guess sell that or. Okay, I have to get this running crud down. Because I'm not very good at these. There we go. Let's see, what are you? Ooh, a great scythe. Interesting. That was worth that little jump puzzle there. So I think up in that tower it's a giant and he's throwing spears because you can kind of see him in the distance in that fog. You kind of see him moving, I guess. I think it's him who's throwing those things. So, all right. I'm gonna try again and get that hollowed bone. Let's sprint across, sprint across, sprint across, sprint across, sprint across. Sprint, 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 sprint. Yeah, you kind of have to like time it perfectly because the explosion itself is just gonna fucking hit you. Okay, you can kind of jump it. I don't like this. I don't know where I'm supposed to, it kind of looks like I'm supposed to go over here. No, don't fall down! Oh. Stupid roll after the jump. Blood loss. I might die right here. Just freak out so I can hit you and you die. God damn, man. See, now I'm trying to rush because I want to get through that and get my souls back and do all these things. Where are my souls? My souls are over there. Okay, and they're in the house. Boom. Alright, now we're gonna try and run, try and run, try and run, try and run. Jump! Jump! Okay. Jump! This is not gonna happen. This is not gonna happen! Okay, I'm inside. Give me some of my souls. Give me my souls. Okay, whew. Alright, you. Okay, you died there. Alright, so it's like around. Here! Oh god, don't let me die! Come on, get up, get up, get up, get up, get up, get up, get up! Get up. Okay, now. Oh god, come on, get up! No! Oh my god! Oh, those jumping, man, this jumping is terrible. Lordy. Let's check out that gear that I got, though. Like, that armor. So, shrine handmaiden will prepare new items. So, okay, so give that to the shrine. So, I got this. I already have that. Great scythe I can use. Doesn't do as much. So, I have a blue wooden shield. Again, not as much, but it'll... Okay. And then I have the cleric's hat. Oh, so I gain the cleric's armor. Alright. So, that's kind of cool. Happy about that. And I got the bone, which means then I can upgrade my Estus flasks. Yeah, kind of let them tire out, I guess, would be a good thing. And then you hit them twice and they kind of stumble. So, kind of let them tire out a little bit. Kind of curious if he would give me an other great machete that he gave me, but I don't think so. I haven't been up this way. Is anything even here? No, it doesn't look like it. Alright, let's go see if I can grab my souls. Wherever they are. Oh, they're all the way over there! That's not good. That's not good at all. That's not good at all. Okay, good. Go, 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 go. Oh god, I'm stuck down here. Nope, nope, nope. Where are they going? Firebomb. It's not attacking me right now. So that means I can maybe grab some of these things. Reinforced club. I don't know. Should I even attempt this? Nope. Okay. I blocked it, and he got killed, so. Okay. Alright, so far this has been a decent run. So far that was decent. I'm decent. I'm happy about that. Got the thing. I've gotten some equipment. Okay, he's gonna go. I'm like the only thing, so he's gonna... Don't even know what that was. Oh, he still got me even though I was on the side of the building. Come on. Alright, so that's enough of that, I think. I think it's time that we go and investigate what the hell is throwing these things. I think it's the giant. Oh my god. So we're going to have to try and talk to him and ask him to politely stop. I'm going to try and not get killed. Okay, what's this say? Could this be a Lord of Cinder? Okay. Oh yeah, there's the bloat. He's a boss over there. Be wary of pointless. And then this is a large door. So I think if you want to, you can talk to the giant and he becomes your friend as long as you talk to him before you kill the bloated tree. I believe that's what it is. I'm going to go and test that out. Doggy? Hey, doggy. Hey, Poochie Poochie. I don't know what you're hiding. What do you got? Ember! So here's a dog. So, I mean, up in that tower was where. Come on, homeboy. This must be where, close to where the guy who killed me with the pot is, I feel like. I hear. Okay, there's people up there. So I think that's the dude with the pot over there. I think. Are you guys gonna try and attack me? Is anybody gonna try and kill me? No? Nobody's gonna try and kill me? Or is that the dude with the pot? That's the dude with the pot. Tire him out. Tire out. Oh, good. Good job. Good last attack. Whew. What the hell? You like a pot full of meat? That's disgusting. Okay. Let's get some Estus Flask, because I know that they're going to be throwing fire bombs. I don't like this at all. How am I supposed to get up there? Because I know they're going to throw firebombs at those things. And try and blow them up, which I don't want them to do. What are you? Soul of Unknown Traveler? Okay, that's worth a firebomb in my opinion. How am I supposed to get up there? Yes, I'll take that. Jeez, I keep forgetting to push A. Is it like through there? Beware of ambush. Thank you for that hint. Thank you so much for that hint. That was a good hint. Okay. Doesn't look like I can do anything from here. There's two of those bucket guys over there. Do I have to go down inside? Oh, Oh, there's a group of them over there. Alright, so let's see. Is this the way inside? Okay, there seems to be something blocking the way. A dog! Hey, doggy! You guys seem to be guarding something sometimes. Okay, let's see. Oh, this is the sewer. Ugh. I never liked those places. So that's going to be up there is going to be where the giant is. So let's see if I can't pull him over a little bit, these guys. Take him out one by one. It'll be great. Firebomb. I appreciate the firebomb. Okay, he's going to come running over. Please tell me you're going to fall. Oh, shit. I didn't realize he could throw. Okay, he's gonna come at me as a meat hook. It's like a slashing contest at this point. Okay, are you gonna try and throw the meat pot at me? No. Yep. Okay, let's take a swig here. Come on. Oh god. Way faster than they look. Alright, so at least that's kind of this area cleared. A little bit. But hopefully he doesn't come after me. Kind of want to fight him though. Enjoy the firebomb. And you're gonna probably throw that at me. Nope. No. Okay. Whew. Oh, that was close. And as you pull out your axe, you're dead. Or your butcher's blade, your giant machete, whatever the hell, the saw, you're dead. Okay. Now, that'd be nice if there was something over here. Of worth. Okay, I'm not going to complain about that too much. Ooh! Ooh! You big-ass mongrel. So, is there something back here? Another dog. Yeah, that's right, you got kicked in the face. Alluring skull. Okay. Damn, that dog jumped out of nowhere and scared the hell out of me. Because now I have to climb the tower. What the hell are you? Oh god. Are you a good guy? Read messages. What did it say? Good fella ahead, but not here. Okay, so he's not a good guy? Let there be stabbing in their back. Don't you dare. Okay, so don't attack him. I think up top is the good fella. Like, he's the giant. Okay. Time for friendship. Oh! Hey there!
Oh, pardon me, I was absorbed.
I remember him from Dark Souls, I think it was Dark Souls 1.
I am Siegvert of Katarina. To be honest, I'm in a bit of a pickle. Have you ever walked near a white birch only to be struck by a great arrow?
Yes.
Well, if I'm not mistaken, they come from this tower. Whoever it is, I'm sure I can talk some sense into them. But I have to find a way up. And that's just the trouble. Well, that does... This lift with a little warming up, I got to you.
Okay, so... like that.
This lift.
Okay, come see.
With a...
Okay, so what, I have to do this? Yes! Alright, so yeah, there's another secret thing. I think you can talk to... there's a giant up here. I think you can talk to him or something. I remember there... this being, like, was a thing, like a secret. Oh my god, there's a fire demon thing over there. Okay, and I don't have Siegfried with me. So I think I'm gonna die. Alright, that might have been a big mistake. Because I think you're supposed to go and have him help you. Oh, Lordy Jesus, there's a demon in there. Is there a way down that I don't have to fight the demon? Homeward Bone. Secret. Okay, there's a secret this way. Keep my shield up. Secret my ass. Oh my god, that thing is fucking creepy! Holy crap. Okay. Come on. Please tell me you can fall. That'd be glorious. Oh, so I guess this could be an area where I could kind of, like, shoot
no,
him?
You should have waited. Well, it's too late now. I, Siegward of the Knights of Katarina, fight by your side.
Okay, well, you're kind of stuck now. Sweet! Alright, he's on my side now. Okay, doesn't do a lot. I'm doing a decent amount of damage. And he's at least blocking a lot of what I'm... oh, wow, okay, that wasn't even that hard. I was being a pansy for no reason. Fire jam!
That was quite a performance. But you mustn't get in over your head. We unkindled must put our duties first. But for the moment, we've a toast to make. To your valor, my sword, and our victory to
our
honor.
Victory and our honor and everything.
Long may the sun shine.
Talk.
Well, I'm getting the only thing to do, really, after a night.
So he's gonna have himself a nap. Okay. So I just killed this fire demon. And then I can still get on top of the tower, I guess. At some point. Large club. Wow, I have to say, you find things way easier in Dark Souls 3 than I feel like you found it in any other Dark Souls. Like, seriously. Like, it's nice. I'm happy. Because this... I'm somebody who gets easily brought into a game by, like, loot and things. Even if they're not even, like, crazy loot. Let's see if there's any way I can get on top of that tower. Well, there's the giant. See, you can see him. He's right there. So I have to go to there and talk to him. I think I have to do it before the killing the bloated tree. But I don't trust... I don't think I'm going to be able to ever get up there. Because I need to find a way back there. And I jumped down from there, so it's not like I can go there. Shite. I might be screwed to talk to that giant. Or at least until I go back that way. Then I have to fight through all those dudes again. Dark Souls. Dark Souls, why are you so mean? Okay, I feel like somebody's gonna drop down on me. There's a trap around here. I don't like it. I don't trust it. I think that dude's gonna jump down. Okay, so far nobody jumped down. That didn't seem... Okay. I don't know what that red pillar thing. I'll check it out later. I would love it if I could get to a bonfire. I know. I feel like somebody here is a bad guy. Yep, there you are. Read message. Be wary of monster. Okay. There's that one. Is there one closer? It's just him. Nope, there's more than one. Shit, I jumped like a bitch right there. Alright, well they're not exactly tough. You kind of just have to keep your distance and swing. Just one time. Because if you get too close, it still hurts you. So, alluring skull. Not like I needed that, but whatever. I'll take it. I'm happy with that. Alright, now I'm up here. Not like that gives me anything. Traveling forth. What's to say? Be wary of beast. Okay, I'm assuming... Oh, there you are, doggy. Oh, another one. Ooh, damn. Quick reflexes on my part. And you're a beast. Okay. Well, I'm getting those souls, man. Up. Be wary of mob. Okay, so it's gonna be a bunch of them. The fuck is this? Oh god, that's a bunch of those cleric guys. Okay. And I don't think I have anything to kind of... Yeah, I don't have any more firebombs. God. Lordy Jesus. I'm gonna try and run past him. Just gonna try and run past him. I said just gonna try. Oof. That's all I want. Try and run past him if I can. I don't even know where I'm going. Flynn's Ring. Did I really just come up this way to get Flynn's Ring? Is that the church that I need to go to? No, because the tower is over there, so. And I think they're kind of stuck. So I would go down this way here. And down this way here, I guess. Okay, oh please give me a bonfire, guys. Please give me a bonfire. Homeward bone. Okay, this person probably just fell and died. Oh god, this is one of those dropping puzzles. Oh god, this is not good. Oh god. Okay, made that. Okay, mirrors, vest, and stuff. Okay, what does it say? Ring ahead. Oh, right here. Clorinthes ring. Right? That one gives you, like, increased... Raise the stamina level. I can't use it. And then this one's lowers equip load... Lowering equip load increases attack. Oh, wow. Okay. So, let's put those bitches on. What is this? Restores HP and boosts. Okay. Red bug pellet. Temporarily boosts fire damage absorption. Alrighty. So this is going to improve my stamina recovery, which is great. I don't know if I like this. Please give me a bonfire. Please give me a bonfire. Is there a bonfire somewhere? Okay, that's going to let me walk back that way. Okay. Shit. Not gonna like this. And I guess that's like a door into a boss fight, I'm assuming. Oh no. Oh good, great. This is back to the bloated place. Sweet. Alright, so I've cleared out this whole area. So now I can go back and try and get the giant on my side. I wish there was another bonfire near here. But there appears not to be. Oh, there's stuff down there. I'm assuming that's where like rats and shit are. You can hear twinkles. You hear the twinkles. Is it that's twinkling? Or do I have a little one of those Titanite lizards hiding around here? I don't know. Okay. Yeah, I'm not gonna fuck with that guy. Everyone says don't. That appears to be another dungeon. I would love it. Love it, love it, love it, love it, love it. Wonder what's down there. Anyways, I guess that's probably down to the sewers too. Alright, let's go up and talk to that giant. Young Light Birch.
I help.
Sweet. Vision of Sadness. So he's gonna stop shooting his giant ass bow and arrows, I guess, at me? Down that way? Is that everything up her? I mean, I'm assuming this is gonna say, praise the ring. Praise the ring? There's a ring in here? Talk.
I help.
Help anytime. I know. I know, I heard you. So I guess that's that. So this will bring us back down. I guess we should go down and see what's down that way. I feel like there's a lot of sparsity between like bonfires, like a big gap between where they would be. Normally. I feel like in front of that boss there should be a bonfire, usually. So, I'm kind of worried because I got a lot of souls and I don't have a bonfire. I mean, I could use an ember and gain all my health back and more health. If this becomes a fight, yeah, I'm in the sewers. This is not good. Let's scope it out a little bit. Okay, so far nothing. Okay, I think, I've seen this also too. He is like a big, like, knight guy, and he will drop, like, a ice sword, but I don't feel like I'm at the level to take him yet, so I'm gonna go back up and be a pansy, and maybe just take the hearthstone, not hearthstone. Wow. Bonfire. Back. Because that's how much of a little bitch I am. Seriously, there should be a freaking bonfire. Time for friendship. Yes, 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 yes. What about down this way? Tell us down this way. Oh, this is some cleric. Oh, okay, so I have to go through the sewers to get them. And I don't trust you. You seem to be. I'm assuming you're going to be like the guard for that person. Obviously, a big into the Dark Souls lore. I would totally be into the Dark Souls lore. I think it's the lore is actually really, really cool. It's just like, I feel like I don't have time to sit down and enjoy it as much as I should because it's such a trying game to get through. And like everything, I guess after recordings I could always sit down and read more about the lore and stuff. A transposing K kiln lies within the belly. Great curse-ridden tree ahead. I know this is a boss, but I don't think there's a bonfire here. Could this be a, yeah, there's a lord. But I don't see any bonfires, and I kind of don't want to start the boss fight with the health that I have. I mean, I know how to get through it, so, and it's not like it's that far from that bonfire, so I'm going to gather all the things here that now that the guy is going to stop shooting at me, and then head back, level up, and then in the next part, the first thing we're going to do is take out the bloated tree. Young White Birch, Ember, Fading Soul. I think that's everything, right? Yeah, I think that's everything. So we're going to go back to the bonfire, go back home to the Firelink Shrine, level up, and then end it there, and then the first thing I'm going to do in the next part, oh god, I thought that was another, I thought that was a bad guy, I was like, oh my god, what the hell is this? It's just a ghost. And then the first thing I'm going to do in the next part is I'm going to fight the bloated tree, or the cursed bloated tree, whatever the fact it's called. Alright, so I'm going to, once we get back to Firelink Shrine, I'm going to end it. And this part, well, technically part 3 because the live stream will be part 1, but I'm going to end this part of Dark Souls 3. So, as always, guys, thank you so much for joining me. I hope you guys are enjoying this Let's Play of Dark Souls 3. And I hope that this episode might have given you some hints or tricks or things to look for, oops, if you start playing Dark Souls yourself. I'm going to continue and try and find hidden things in the world if I can, so that way I can maybe share some tips and tricks with you guys on what I found. But yeah, that's Dark Souls 3, my Let's Play part, I'm going to say part 2, I hope you guys had fun, I had fun, it's definitely quickly becoming my favorite Souls game. Demon Souls was my favorite. Simply just because I liked a lot of the classes and I liked the world and stuff like that. So this is definitely, out of the three Souls games, this is definitely the best Souls game. So if you're thinking about picking up, I'd highly suggest picking it up, especially if you've played the other Souls games or Demon's Souls or Bloodborne, though V1 Bloodborne is a much faster paced game, as I'm sure you've heard other people say. But yeah, so that's the end of part 2. Thank you so much, guys, for joining me. Thank you so much for all the support that you guys have been giving me recently. I truly appreciate it. You guys are fantastic, phenomenal, amazing people. Thank you so much for supporting this little dream of mine. And I hope maybe one day that I inspire you guys to try out YouTube, try out to do something that you love and have passion for. Because truly, I don't think I've ever have been happier in my life than I have been this past few months being able to do this stuff. So, as always, guys, stay enthusiastic. Thank you so much for joining me. And I'll catch me next time in my next Dark Souls 3 Let's Play, which will come up on Friday afternoon. Love you guys so much. Thank you. Bye-bye. Hey, guys. Seb here. I continued to play some Dark Souls 3 after I had cut the stream. The recording. And nothing major, I just was leveling up and checking out the new gear that I picked up. And you know what I did? You know how there's fog and all that stuff down there? Well, basically, all you gotta do is continuously roll into it for a little bit, and you will actually just pass through it. Now, if you want to get in the tower and get inside the top of Fire Link Shrine and get all the goodies and stuff, you're originally supposed to pay 20,000 souls, get the tower key, unlock that tower, and that's how you get in. But you can kind of cheat. So what you got to do is you got to sprint and jump up from that tree onto this ledge over here. And then you can walk up here and you can enter the Top of Fire Link Shrine and get some of the goodies. So I'm just going to kind of show you what you can kind of get. Also, if you go down now, if you get out and you jump, there should be graves over this way, right? A couple graves. Yeah, see? If you fall down from there and continue going this way, you're going to find the guy who has the katana sword that's great for dexterity builds. He's kind of a tough guy. I haven't fought him yet. Maybe after I go through that guy, he's right there. He has the katana and he gives you some armor. I don't know how good the armor is, but yeah. So that's how you can do that. I'm just going to try and get into the top of Firelink Shrine. Where is it? 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 Here we go. And go through these rafters. So you're going to kind of want to, like, of course, carefully walk through these rafters. You can, I think... I got Esther Shards up here. And then of course there's the crow. If you leave, if you get on top of there, that's kind of what I think the tower's for. You can get up there and you can leave them baubles and they will bring you things. So there's an illusion here right across from where you enter. And you can keep walking, keep walking, keep walking. And then you jump down here and there'll be a chest. Now you know this is not a mimic chest because the chain is curved and not straight out. But if you never are sure, feel free to always swing your sword. It takes a couple hits to break a real chest, but the mimic will react instantly. So be sure to hit it once and test it out. But now we get the coveted silver serpent ring. Now what this does is that it's going to allow me to gather more souls. I believe that's what it does. So let's over here. So fallen foes yield more souls. So yeah, that's one of the little trinkets you can get. I think that would be a pretty cool thing to get, especially early in the game if you're trying to like level up and so on and so forth. And then you kind of just drop down from here. Yeah, it's gonna hurt a little bit, but screw it, you know. So yeah, that, I just wanted to show you that little secret. You can kind of get some things pretty easy, pretty early. And I'm gonna go and try and fight the guy now, and the for the katana. Jesus, I'm kind of like losing my thing. I might show that fight. I might pause it, and if the fight goes kind of well, I might bring it back, the stream back. All right. So I'll see you guys in a bit. All right. So yeah, I actually beat the guy in one hit. Well, not one hit. In my first try. So basically, yeah, he's a super dexterous guy. He's going to jump around. He's really quick. As you can see, I have very little health. If I didn't use the ember before, I would have probably died. Also, I used the charcoal pine resin to put flame damage on my sword, and that helped a lot. So yeah, now I got the Uchigatana, the master attire, and the master gloves. So if you are going for a more dexterous build, that's sort of the weapon you kind of want to get early if you can. And I'm assuming this is going to be something, again, with the tower key that I'm going to have to, you know, eventually get, I guess. So yeah, so those are a couple of the little secrets that you can do to maybe get some early good better gear, especially a better weapon if you're going for a dexterous build. So thank you guys so much for joining me again. I'm going to add this little bit to the end of the video. So no worries, you don't have to wait till the next part to get some of these hints. All right, thanks so much. Talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.